Hey guys, my name is Koyanche, and welcome to episode 15 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you're able to automate the Immersive Engineering Metal Press, and in this episode we'll start talking about automating the Exenhylo Lava Production. So let's get started! So I've been suggested to automate the Exenhylo mod using Logistics Pipes a couple of times, and the first thing that came to mind is the lava automation using the Crucible. Of course, there's a lot of other stuff you can automate, so if you want to see more, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. So let's run you guys by what I set up. So, of course, like always, I got myself a logistics power junction, though in this situation a little bit different, as I'm not using a creative energy cell, but an X-ray utilities lava generator, as this system is powering itself. Yes, this system generates enough lava to actually power itself. Pretty awesome. To actually make the lava, you will need some cobblestone, for which I used a barrel to actually store it in, and an igneous extruder with a couple of upgrades to generate a stack of cobblestone at a time, just to make sure that even if you have a very massive network that produces a lot of lava, you won't run out of cobblestone to do so. Of course, I hooked up a provider logistics pipe to this to actually make it supply to the network, and a logistics fluid supplier to the actual lava generator set to keep lava stocked. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Then, of course, the main part why you are here, the actual automation of the crucible. This is surprisingly simple, believe it or not. All you have to do is hook up a supplier logistics pipe, and in this case I set it to request infinite cobblestone, so this thing will try to always keep it filled with cobblestone, which is of course the thing that you want. And on the other side I hooked up a logistics fluid extractor pipe, which will, as the name would suggest, extract fluid from the adjacent inventory to any place in the network. Then right there, I got myself an open blocks tank, hooked up with a logistics fluid basic pipe, which is set to lava, so pretty much this is the default route where any lava in the network is allowed to go to. And on the other side, I got myself a logistics fluid provider pipe, just to actually, supply it to this logistics fluid supplier to power this logistics power junction. So yes, as you can see, this system is actually net gaining both power and lava, and yeah, it's pretty much self-efficient, so that is pretty awesome. And basically, that's all you need to actually automate this. Don't forget that you also need some sort of heat source underneath the crucible, for example, some fire or lava to actually make it function. Pretty cool. And with that, I pretty much want to wrap up this episode. But like I said, if you have any other suggestions, whether it be with the Exenhylo mod or any other mod that you would like to see automated using logistics pipes, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. So be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And like always, I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.